My name's David Readman, and I'd like to welcome you to my Tuesday night fun and games live show. Every Tuesday night on YouTube at 8 o'clock. Come and join in. Hi, my name's David Readman, singer of Pink Cream 69, Voodoo Circle, and many more. And I've just released the second single, The Fallen, from my upcoming record, Medusa. Came out on the 14th, go and check it out. The Fallen is available on all good streaming sites. We're making this record together. Come and help me. Come and take a quick look. At the video on my YouTube channel. The link is below. Thanks for watching. Have a great night. Bye bye. Good evening. My name's David Readman, and if you just tuned in tonight, my name is David Readman. And maybe you're new, maybe you're tuning in for the first time tonight. This is my Tuesday night Fun and Games live show. And I started this back in January, February of this year, and it was very cold then. So what I'm up against at the moment, of course, is that it's today in the Netherlands, when I looked at the weather, it was 25 degrees, which makes my Medusa studio almost unbearable. It was about 2 years ago when I made the Voodoo Circle record. 2 years? No, not 2 years, Dave. 5 years ago, and I did make the last one in the summer as well, but 5 years ago I made the Voodoo Circle record and it was burning hot. It was absolutely incredible. But anyway, either way, great to have you online. Maybe you've dragged your laptop or you've dragged the whole TV outside to your barbecue. Hopefully you can hear me. That helps. Let's have a look online first. I got a fun packed show for you tonight. There hasn't been a reveal recently, mainly because you know, this is the third single and it's already been an amazing wonder, you could say, that the guys have gifted me 2 times with reveal videos and videos for the video. Of course, I just recently released my second single, which was last month, because today is the 1st, I believe, 1st of June. It's actually June. The weather changed recently. Up until now, it was raining every single day. So I released my single on the 14th, which was an amazing feeling. We're making this record together, as we all know. And yeah, the guys gave me everything I needed. But on this record, it's different. I got a few different people involved. And of course, it's not always the same situation. Not everybody's got a camera, not everybody's got time and stuff like that, but it's good. So tonight I'm going to do a little reveal of the upcoming guitar player on the third single. Now you might think, well, Dave, you'd normally release around the 13th, 14th of a month. True enough, but not this month. It's been absolute mayhem. I got lots of things going on. I got an Italian project, a Pink Cream 69 record. The guys are knocking at the door. But before I carry on, let's make sure you guys can hear me and let's have a look who's online. Here we go. Let's go to the main chat view. Here we go. We've got Kate online, which is absolutely incredible. I hope you're well. You've not been very good from the vaccination process, I believe. That's me this week on Friday at 3 o'clock, which is incredible. So that's going to be hopefully the start of a new long journey. And we got Diana S. Good evening from California, Calabasas, somewhere around like that. We got Mario Kitan! Tiana Tapas. Great to have you online. Barcelona! Or Baradona, actually. My Spanish connection. Lovely to have you online. It's always great weather there anyway, so you're probably barbecuing every night. There we go. Sarah's online. Far too warm. I know that Sarah mentioned recently she... Or somebody mentioned something online. I noticed they were complaining about, you know, when's it going to be winter again? I love this weather. I've been telling myself, I've been burning my old leather skin recently the last couple of days. And it's comfortable. It's so comfortable. I will probably, after the live tonight, I will probably go out on my bike and enjoy the nice sundown on the evening. So it's going to be amazing. Adrian Witt is in the house, clocking in. Now, I just spoke to Adrian recently. He's probably sat on the couch with his lovely wife. And unfortunately, he's going to have to move quite soon. But he's an old friend of mine. I haven't seen him for many, many years. For donkey years. Donkey's years. And hopefully he's going to send me a couple of riffs over. And maybe this guy's going to be involved in a record. Let's see. It'd be nice to bring some taste of Burnley. Is it Burnley? Well, he moved actually into the outback, actually. To a place which is like a valley, actually, and in between it floods in the winter, which is a bit of a sickness, I suppose. But it's a nice area, quite mysterious. And I think a member of Take That actually is from that sort of area-ish. I think it's called Mark. That's funny. A bit of trivia for you there. Don't know him. Spirit is online. Cheer on, my friend. We're doing good tonight. We've got 14 people. I wasn't sure about tonight because it is incredible weather. And a lot of people do prefer to watch football, which is not on tonight, but football is important just as much as barbecuing and drinking beer. So believe me, I'm so glad that everybody's involved tonight. Absolutely incredible. I wash my hair on purpose and I put my favourite t-shirt on for you guys. I am wearing shorts, but you'll not get to see my legs tonight. Mari, haha, you're amazing. Oh, thank you. I don't know what I've done, but that's nice. Mari, good to see you. ¿Qué tal? ¿Tiene tapas? Sí, tiene tapas. ¿Tiene para todos? Sí, tiene para todos. Nutsoko, hello from Tokyo. Isn't that incredible? We got somebody from Tokyo on tonight. You know, I mean, My Woman from Tokyo comes to mind. That beautiful song. Kate gave me an answer there. Kate's getting... it's still not good, but she's getting there slowly. It'll work itself out. Let's hope that we can deal with this. And Akhtar's online. We're doing well tonight. Number 16. Hello, everybody. Lovely to see you, Akhtar. Brit is online. Wie geht's dir? Das ist der absolute Hammer. Du bist ja früh heute Abend, ne? Hoffentlich können... Am Freitag ist es soweit für mich. Und ich krieg auf jeden Fall der erste... Spritz oder wie man sagt, einfach na, die erste Spritz. Und glaube im Juli wieder. Und im Juli gibt es vielleicht eine Möglichkeit von einem Konzert. Und ich hoffe, wenn ich in Deutschland bin, dass ich auf jeden Fall mit meinem zwei Spritzer, mit meinem zwei Impfung, dass ich auf jeden Fall was machen kann. Das wird mir auf jeden Fall was freuen, und ich glaube, nächstes Jahr geht's wieder los. Here we go. Hello, Mr. Readman. I'm at work, ready with my headphones to listen to you. Oh, Gracie. ¿Qué tal? ¿Qué tal? Sí, sí, ¿qué tal? Bueno, bueno. As you can see, I'm on the strange drink tonight. What's it called? Kong. Kong Strong. I've never actually read it. I've never actually read what it says on the tin. Until tonight. It's absolutely disgraceful. 19 people online. So we got Spain. We got Mark. We got Mark online. Hey, Junge. Wie ein du Hopfdommen unter you. Sag mal. Ja, das war leuk, hè? Ja, hier in Nederland is echt best lekker weer en ik ben verbaasd. Ik moet echt zeggen, ik ben echt heel verbaasd. Zoveel mensen online vanavond en ik dacht, weet je wat? Ik heb laatst ik heb laatst eigenlijk alleen Engels gepraat. En dat is wel lekker, maar ik moet toch een beetje, een klein beetje Nederlands leren nog. Duits kan ik een beetje. Een heel klein beetje Spaans. Pequeño. Hola! Good to see you online. We got Holland online. We got Spain online. We got Japan online. We got Brazil online. We got Adrian online. He's near Todd. We got Tomlinson online. Where Todd Bus goes, you know, I used to get Todd Bus into Burn a lot, you know. Bloody hell, fire them, we're bloody dead. Anyway, tell your wife not to widen the doors, not in this house, but in the other. That's probably a better idea. And Mark, he calls me Mr. Readman. It sounds quite official. If he knew me, he wouldn't call me Mr. Readman anymore. Absolutely incredible. Absolutely incredible. We got 19 online, considering the weather situation. It is rather fantastic. I am absolutely physically and mentally blown away. If you're tuning in for the first time tonight, I think last week we had a couple of new people, and that was really cool. And that's what we're trying to do. You know, we're trying to send a message out about this record we're making together. As you can see, I've got my important T-shirt on with the artwork from the record. And it's been in the wash for the last couple of weeks. But finally made it tonight. Put your hands up if you're watching this stream outside on your veranda enjoying the sun. Definitely not me, but I'll be out there later on enjoying this fantastic weekend, evening. But apparently on Thursday, the weather's apparently turned. Because you see, from the UK, we talk about the weather all the time. And everybody thinks it rains every day in the UK. It doesn't. Almost. But when it does, it does. And when it rains, it pours. Who's online? We got... What? Oh. What can I do, Ben? Ha ha. Face no supper. Somebody. Oh, my machine's making a lot of noise. Craig Boyd. Hi, David. The girls with binoculars front row do the... Yes, absolutely. Craig, yeah. It was absolutely mayhem. They were dressed as in these sort of captains. Suits with hats and everything, and they had like these binoculars, and they were always at the front of the gigs, and just absolute mayhem. I don't think they slept a wink for a week, I suppose. But when you're on those boats, we're talking about the boat again. When you're on those boats, you don't sleep much. I mean, I slept a bit. I was a bit jet lagged in the first couple of days, and when Craig got his dreads, his braids, I didn't sleep at all anymore, man. It was incredible. Okay, thank you so much. And Mark says, I'm in the freezer. It's so true, though. It's so warm here. It's like night and day. It's probably really great in the UK as well, in Germany as well, I imagine. But here, it is. It gets so... It just goes like that. And I thought that when I moved here coming from Germany, it's not far. It's like an hour. Of course, you can't really go there at the moment, unfortunately. But, you know, you go over the boat, it's like an hour. And I really thought that, you know, where I actually lived in Germany, which was like 6 hour drive, 5 hour drive, which was incredible weather. It's like being a holiday, you know. And I thought I'd come here, it wouldn't be the same, but it is, it's burning. But if I would go to Karlsruhe where I lived, I remember last year I went there for a couple of gigs, which did work out, thank God, even though we're in the big sea time. And I went there, and the weather was just incredible. It was just burning. It was cracking the flags, man. Okay, it says it's 21. It's actually 25 here. Good to see you, Mark. I can't actually see you, but you can see me, that's for sure. So anyway, let's not get sidetracked too much tonight, because tonight, quick drink of this strange stuff, Kong Strong. But tonight is about a reveal, and I'm going to reveal, because I've asked him for a video, but he's a busy guy. But the way it looks, he's probably going to write a song with me on this record as well, because he sent some of his songs over. So, you know, I'm talking to these people, and I said, look, have you got any songs? And why the hell not? You know what I mean? He sent me like 5-6 songs, and there's one song which I really like, and he sent me the stuff over. This is going to be like down the line, but sounds really good. Anyway, I met this young man. I've got a nice video for you. It's not going to be like a video like saying, you know, obviously it's nice to work with David and he's such a great guy. It's not going to be a video like that. I found a nice video of me and him actually on stage, because we met in 2015 for the first time. We were younger men back then. We were probably the same age. We were about 45 at the time. And he looks really good for his age, does this young man. And he blew me away straight away. I thought, wow, this is a great guitar player. We've got to do something. And what he did, which was quite extraordinary, he, you know, we'd met. I was selling my CDs at the time, the first album, first solo CD. And I was selling those. And he I think he bought one, or I gave him one or whatever. I gave him one. And the next day he came back and said, wow, I love the record, David. I've learned one of the songs on acoustic. And I was like, whoa, man. You know, this is incredible. So the second night on this little tour that we were doing with a guy called Martin Engelin from Go Music, an incredible musician. And he does a tour every month in the area in Germany, in Cologne and Krefeld and that kind of area in Germany, like pretty much over the border. And he invited me, and I worked with a drummer called Hansen Sander, Dutch drummer, who's from the Venlo area. He's an incredible drummer. He's in many Praying Mantis, I think. And so I met this guy. I was about to say his name. You know, I'm going to tease you a little bit, so you got to watch this video. But I met this guy for the first time, and it was the second night we played this song with acoustic. You know, I had to remember the lyrics. I was like, oh my god, this is incredible. You know. So we continued to do that. It was just so fantastic. And I said to him, look, if I ever make another record, a solo record, you're definitely going to be involved. And we did some other stuff after that, little bits and bats and stuff. But we sort of lost touch a little bit in a way, because I think he's living in the Dusseldorf area. And great guy, fantastic guy. So I'm going to show you a little bit of video now. It's in a small club. By the way, it sounds a bit rough, but I'm on stage with him. Martin Englund's playing bass, one of my great friends and guy I've been working with for the last 15 years. Was introduced to him actually by Alex Bayrod from Voodoo Circle. He got me involved in this thing, Go Music. And on the tour, you basically, on the first day, you meet everybody. I met the guitar player, I met the drummer. I met, of course, Martin, who I know very well. And then that day, we look at the set list and we go on stage and we play for 2 hours. And we never practice. We never rehearse. We go and do it, and we play a 10-day tour. Works every time. Small clubs in Germany. Of course, now at the moment, it's not possible. But was absolutely incredible. And that's when I met this young man. I need my glasses for this. Here we go. Check out this one. Left, you'll hopefully be able to see Mr. Zibby Krabs on guitar. Yeah. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, as you can see, that is Mr. Zibby Krebs on guitar, a good friend of mine. This guy is actually, he's got a quite a German name, Zibby Krebs, you could say, but he's actually a Polish guy. He's from Poland. Now, I wanted to get Zibby online tonight, maybe on a live interview, but we got a slight problem, and I don't mean this, what I'm going to say, in a strictly negative way. When I speak to Zibby, I speak to him in German. Now, Zibby's been in Germany probably about 6-7 years. So when I speak to Zibby in German, it's still a bit rough, kind of, you know, but it works. But we need to speak English probably for an interview. Now, Zibby's English is worse. And my Polish is absolutely terrible. So it's kind of like, how honestly can I do an English interview online? Like I say, I don't mean it negative, but this is how it is, you know what I'm saying? So we're gonna have to cut that out. But I am so proud, I'm so really proud to have Zibby Krebs involved in this next song. And maybe you realized on the title there, the next song is going to be called Madam Medusa. So basically, it was important for me to get at least one song on this record, and it was planned with this song, the third single, which will be out at the end of this month. Still got to find some kind of date, because at the end of the day, without a record company, I can do whatever I want. It's going to be a great song. I'm just finalizing the vocals. It's going to get mixed. I'm still waiting for some of the videos to come in and some of the reveals. The bass player, by the way, to the Spanish connection, is from Spain. We got a Spanish bass player, so we're getting everybody involved. We still need somebody from the UK, I guess, but that's all right. I got a drummer on this one of these tracks. Also on the record is from the UK, so all the bases are covered. Coming back to Zibby, I sometimes get jealous of his hair, man. This guy's got a lot of hair, man. This is an incredible, friendly, cool guy. Amazing musician, as you can see. And like I said, I met him, it's already 5 years ago. I knew he had to be involved, and he was, well, I remember when I contacted him, he was over the moon. And the way it looks, we still got to wait and see, but the way it looks, he's definitely going to be involved on one of the tracks also that we'll write together on this record. So the plan's coming, you know, it's all coming together. So don't forget, the third single is called Madam Medusa. And yeah. The plan's coming together. The only slight problem is that I've got to do all the work. But hey, I ain't complaining. Let's have a look. Let's have a look at some comments. What's going on? So let's see. Down at the local pub in a curry on a Wednesday night. Was he completely pissed? Love song. Yes, you're right. It's one of the only David. Now to go. Love Les Paul sounds. Yeah. Das ist schade. Komplett. Ah, very good song title. Thank you very much. Thank you. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. 18 people online. Yeah. So like I said, it's basically the 1st of June. Don't forget, people, to pick up your T-shirts, of course. It's the 1st of June. So, of course, normally we'd be on the 14-day countdown. It's not possible with this track. But I think you guys got enough tracks to listen to at the moment. Two tracks. The third song is in the making. It will be called Madam Medusa. And Gilbert's working on the artwork now. I think the next couple of days I'll be ready to send a mix. That goes quite fast, and then upload to Spotify. And from that moment on, basically, once the video's available at the end of the month, it's basically finishing the rest of the record. A lot of the music, a lot of the recording's been done. I've just pulled in the help of a drummer on one track who actually played with the Scorpions on a tour. And I have a guitar player that's also done lots of different things. Big stuff, involved in very big bands. And he's just agreed to play guitar on a track that we're working on at the moment, a track that I wrote with Julien. So it's business as usual. It's all going really well. Any questions, anybody? Anybody, you know? Let's have a look now. What's it? Yeah, try David Readman. Ah, he's from England. Any questions coming in tonight? 21, that's why it's a world record, isn't it? 21 people online. But let's not, wait a minute. I nearly forgot that. I like to mention everybody's name. Let's go back up the list and let's pick out this young man here. Where is he? Skater Arnold. Hardy Hunt. Hardy David. Arnold, hard me here. Ik vind het best lekker. Je denkt, je hebt vandaag, heb je vandaag de prik gehad, de indenting. Ik ben aan vrijdag, aan de beurt. Daar ben ik wel lekker blij mee. Je bent denk ik vandaag de tweede, denk ik. Zo begrijp ik het. Of de eerste. Maar ik ben wel benieuwd en benauwd voor de, of ik klachten heb. Ik dacht, ja, ik heb helemaal geen zin in klachten te hebben, weet je. Dat ik ziek ben, maar ja, vrijdag, als je vrijdag prik gehad hebt, en dan moet je kijken, zaterdag, zondag, kan je een beetje uitrusten en zo en alles, maar ja, ik ben wel benieuwd en benauwd. Maar ik vind het geweldig dat je bij bent vanavond. Groetjes aan je vrouw. En ja, ik hoop dat binnenkort gewoon we langs en lekker een bakje doen bij jullie. In de achtertuin, hoor. Lekker. I do rock a Medusa look all the time. We moeten snel weer bleren. Bleren. Okay. Great talent. I must admit, I do rock a Medusa. Yeah, I bet. I bet you do. I mean, we met real quick on the boat, so I can't necessarily agree with that. But yeah, I for me on this track, it was important to get the connection, you know, with the title, and this is the track. We've got a nice subject going on, of course. Skaton Arnold. Even Altai, welcome. Daar ben ik blij, man. Nee, man. Geen klachten, joh. snel weer optreden, geen klachten. Dat weet je nooit, man. Dat weet je echt nooit. Als je Astra hebt, AstraZeneca, weet je, dan kan alles gebeuren. Maar ik ga vrijdag, ik krijg Astra. Ik denk beneden 60. Als je boven 60 bent, moet je in Duitsland of in ieder geval moet je dan Astra pakken. Hè? Maar ik denk in Nederland gaan ze niet meer doen. Maar er zijn natuurlijk andere vaccinen. Ja, wat het precies is, ik heb geen idee, man. Maar ja, ik ben wel benieuwd en benauwd, hoor. Anyway, let's go back to the English language. Greg Sontra, thank you very much. 21 people online. And what else did I want to show you? Something. Yeah, like I said, let's go back to the main window. Yeah, as like I said before, I mean, it's just absolute mayhem at the moment. I'm just finalizing the vocals. I've just been sort of messing around with the lyrics a little bit. Waiting for Joe to come back now with the title and the artwork to upload to Spotify and to iTunes and stuff like that. Record will be out at the end, sort of like October, something like that, November, that kind of thing. A lot of the tracks have already been done. I think a couple of tracks I still need to work on and change a little bit and send out to people to play guitar and bass and stuff like that. But that's still going to happen. But it's going really well so far. It was a lot of work the last video, so of course I needed a bit of time to return to normal after that. And my laptop as well needed a bit of help after that one. But looking forward to this third single, Madam Medusa. And I need the videos. So if you're watching tonight, anybody that's playing on this record, on this single, you know, get the videos done. There's nice weather, get outside, get some cool filming done, and we'll get a nice lockdown video. Hou me op de hoogte, David. Dat zou ik doen, man. Lekker bezig. Kein termin. Versuche seit 4 Wochen. Ja, dat is ja komisch, ne? Ich meine, ich kenne Leute. Ich kenne echt Leute in Deutschland, die haben alle 2 gehabt irgendwie. Und dann kann man irgendwie essen gehen, da kann man in verschiedene Shops, da kann man shoppen gehen und alles, sonder Problem, ohne Papierkram zum Beispiel. Und ja, das ist echt schade. Ich meine, ich habe jetzt irgendwie bestimmt wochenlang, monatelang habe ich gesagt, ich will gern diese scheiß Impfung haben einfach. Ne? Und ich habe das irgendwann mal letztens mitgekommen. Da kann man irgendwie mittlerweile, ich bin in die Alterklasse, wo man dann irgendwie online das dann irgendwie bestellen kann. Und Freitag ist soweit. Ich habe keine Angst, aber ich glaube schon am Freitag bin ich schon ein bisschen irgendwie wackelig. 20% constructive question. If Tank play, maybe somewhere in England, do you think you may do any more gigs while over? Maybe even bring Julien and do a solo gig. That's a good question. You know, at the end of the day, if I get to play over in the UK again, I'm going to sidetrack a little bit. The answer to that is yes. All that and yes. You know, I tried recently to book a flight to the UK in July and surprise my mother. Maybe she's watching tonight. Of course, it's not a surprise anymore, is it? Now, the flight from Eindhoven to... This has nothing to do with music, but, you know, it's fun and games and it's 20% constructive and it's 50% mayhem. This is the mayhem bit. And I booked a flight and it's 12 euros, so it's 13 euros one way to Manchester. So it's 26 without any baggage and all that shit. 26 euros return. So you're like, yeah, man, let's buy the whole plane, you know. But, of course, you want a negative test, you know, to get on the plane, fair enough. That's 80 euros, okay. But coming from the Netherlands, because it's amber, so we got red, amber and green, because it's amber, you need to quarantine, apparently, whether it's changed, for 10 days. So that means on the second day of arrival, you need to order a test, which costs £80. So get it delivered to your house. Do the test. You're negative. On the eighth day, you need to test again. And then once you've done the 10-day quarantine, which is absolutely not possible at all, then I think you can go and see your mother. So, of course, that was that. But, I mean, I understand, you know, it's an island. They can do whatever they want. You know, they're not in the EU anymore. And, of course, doing that and keeping it really strict, if they are keeping it that strict, will obviously bring down the levels of the corona and bring some kind of normal back to the island. So, whatever it takes. But, I mean, you know, so about 350,000 million euros later, you can take a 13-euro flight to get there. And Corolla, yeah, die hat auch lang gebraucht, irgendwie für eine Impfung. Yeah, you know, like I said, I know people who got sorted out. It's who you know. You know, if you know a doctor, right, he's possibly going to be able to help you out with that. And if you don't, then you're going to have to wait. And that is, it's a good thing, but it's also a bit wrong, you know. But that's life. That's it. But anyway, I'm going to try and get some new videos coming your way. I at least want to have one reveal. And what I got planned as far as videos concerned is, which is a defo, I got planned a looking back video, like a reveal of looking back on the last two tracks and a little bit more information about, you know, obviously making a video and who was involved and whoever sent me a reveal video, you know, those amazing people. And that's definitely on the cards. Bit of work involved, but at the moment, obviously, this track is you know, really important to get it done and obviously to start making the video, which will be out at the end of the month. And don't forget these crazy t-shirts that I got on tonight. Let's see. You know, I really did try, but it's just not really possible at the moment. You know, like you're coming back to your question about the gigs, of course. You know, if it opens up that much and it's possible to be... I mean, imagine the freedom that we used to have. I mean, it was just, you know, in respect, it was just incredible. I mean, I used to go out on a Thursday, right, go to Germany, you know, and then I'd hang out at my local Irish bar with old friends that I know in Karlsruhe. And then on Friday, I'd do a gig in Timbuktu. Saturday, I'd be somewhere else with a whole different band. Sunday, I'd do a video with a band. And then sometime, you know, Monday I might fly back to Amsterdam, you know. And you just do whatever you wanted, man. It was just an incredible time, you know. And people were sometimes jealous of me when I told them what I got up to and stuff. I had this crazy kind of life. And sometimes you were jealous of people who had a normal job and had normal, you know, normal money and didn't have to fight for the money every month. You know, they had their own businesses. And, you know... But thank God I did these things, you know, when it was possible, of course. And I think we're going to get some kind of normal back, of course, next year once everybody's been vaccinated. But still, it's going to take a bit of time, I think, unfortunately. Sarah says, only know a dentist, and I'm afraid he got our mate a great deal on some black market dentures. Oh, McCoy's is online. David, I've been missing so many of your streams due to work. Cheers. Hey, great to have you online, my friend. Charlie says, don't play with matches. I only know a dentist, and I'm afraid. Yeah. You know, dentists. I bet a dentist probably could help you. Or even a vet. Probably a vet's better. Probably can get hold of a few spare vaccines. And, they're definitely equipped to put it in, like, you know what I mean? There's probably people out there that are buying it anyway from somewhere and just injecting themselves anyway, you know what I'm saying? Especially in Russia. Oh, Lydia needs some singing lessons. When are those starting again? Well, I'm not sure at the moment, you know, what's doable. I was also teaching on Wednesdays in a place called Hormont, which was on the border to Germany. And it's funny because I used to go there one time a month and do like a whole day session at my favorite guy, Eddie Klaasens, music school, and I had an English guy there, I had Dutch guy, I had a Belgium guy, I had German guys. It was incredible. Everybody had sort of like, you know, because everybody in that area there, you get people from Holland, from Belgium, from Germany. It was incredible. I had this incredible day of, you know, a mixture of people, and it was so fantastic. I was just before the corona kicked in, I was just starting to rebuild that. And of course, I was teaching here, of course, private, quite local, in a French studio. It's got an amazing studio. I was teaching there one time a week in the evenings, and I was starting to rebuild that. But this shit happened, and it just stopped the whole thing. And I do miss it. I enjoyed teaching and watching people improve, you know. It's like a carry-on movie. Ja, nou, dat weet ik. De roman is echt te ver. Nee, dat is niet de bedoeling. Daar gaan we echt hier in de buurt proberen weer, weet je. Maar ik praat over toekomst, als het kan. Oh my god, it's like a carry-on movie. You what? What's going on tonight? I'm speechless, and that doesn't happen often. But McCoy says, I'd say, I think we're eight songs are written and more or less recorded, not the vocals. Basically, you know, I get the tracks in front of people, and I do the vocals at the end. Of course, I have demos, and a lot of the stuff's already written. You know, when I work with Julien, the songs are very far. He does a lot of, he's obviously a keyboard player, but he writes a lot of the guitar parts already and stuff like that. Demos are incredible. I have to show you these demos at some point. And I wait until, you know, basically, you know, I get the stuff back from the people, because I prefer that then obviously to put my vocals on top. And then it's really just a case of finalizing, you know, melodies, looking at lyrics, changing stuff, messing around, and until I'm happy. And then Julien, up until now, he did a lot of backing vocals. This is like a talented guy, man. You know, he's also young and everything, you know. So he not only plays a bit of guitar, he's a massive, crazy keyboard player doing all different parts and stuff, very musical. Knows his theory and everything. Also sings, you know. It's just incredible, really. Oh, we've got a few more comments on here. Lydia. Hello, Eric, toch jongen. Laugh like old Sid James. Yeah, true enough. Yeah, I have a bit of a dirty laugh. But, you know, that probably comes from using the diaphragm. You know, when you're singing. You know, it probably comes from that, and I've always had this loud kind of laugh, you know what I mean? And I'm the kind of person who does laugh most of the day, actually, if I'm in a good mood. But people always wonder what you're laughing at, what are you laughing at, you know what I mean? But I might be laughing about a joke that I heard about 3 weeks ago, you know. But anyway, Adrian, I like everybody knows each other on here now. That's really cool. I like that. So we're coming up to quarter to the hour, and just before we before I leave you amazing guys, the GoFundMe is, I think it's sort of standing a bit still at the moment. It might be a bit more at this point, but I might be enough. It's incredible. We're definitely going to get up to that five mark. There's no question about that, which is already amazing. Thanks to everybody again for donating and being part of the GoFundMe. Also, PayPal, of course, is available. There's a link somewhere if you look around, either underneath this video or on past videos, you'll find a PayPal link, which is incredible. The Spotify is also, it's done really well with this last track, actually. I think there's been quite a bit of streaming. So if you obviously want to get back and stream a little bit more on Spotify and help us with that, that's always a good thing. I want to show you the second video, because tonight is a combination of things. I wanted to do a bit of Russian roulette, but that's not going to be tonight. More important things like Mr. Zibby Krebs, of course. He's playing on the third single, Madam Medusa, and he is actually a Polish guy living in Germany for a long time. And as I said before, I wanted to do an interview with him, but I speak to him in German and his German's a bit rough. It's good enough, but it's for an interview, it might be a bit, you know, his English is worse, but my Polish is absolutely terrible. So we're a bit stoked, you know, but maybe we can have a short interview at some point. Be nice to get him on online. He's a great guy, really nice guy, really cool guy, really down to earth guy. A little bit more video of Zibby tonight for you guys to look at and enjoy. A really nice solo. Yeah, what an amazing guy. Zibby Krebs, Polish guy. A guy I met 5 years ago doing the Go Music Tour with Martin Engelin. Hans in Sand on drums from the Venlo area, which, you know, obviously we all met at that time, and I actually worked with Hans a little bit after that, met him a few times. He plays with a few other guys, Dutch guys in Praying Mantis, and some guys from the UK. And yeah, Zibi, I actually played the same stage actually with him at some point later. These were some concerts that he'd organised actually with other people on this amazing stage. I think it was in, I can't remember exactly where it was, but it was possibly in Dusseldorf somewhere or that kind of area. And I went in on a weekend, and it was one of those situations where on the Friday I was playing there, on the Saturday I was somewhere else, and then on a Sunday I'd go down to Karlsruhe, travel right down there. So I was always on the road and always busy, and you know, and like Sarah said, look at that guy's hair, man. There's not a moment of grey in there. Maybe he's grey now after 5 years, I don't know, but incredible guy. And he actually, it's funny because I thought he was a lot younger than me actually when I first met him. And he has a son, and his son's like 20, 21 years old or whatever, looks just like him, right? I think he's a drummer. So incredible. You just couldn't believe that this guy could have a 21-year-old son. Of course, it's possible. But he just seemed so young and so free. You know, it was kind of weird at that time when he told me. But never actually met his son. I think his son's actually in Poland at this time. But yeah, really happy that he's involved, man. Classic music, man. Oh, McCoy's happy 20th birthday to Sanctus Ignus. Thank you so much. Oh, Britta says, so spielen zu können fasziniert mich immer wieder. Ja, es ist da mal. Irgendwann mal macht man das irgendwie in der Umgebung. Im Chaos oder irgendwas mit Zibi. Yeah, like McCoy said, is it 20 years, man? 20 years ago that I sang on the Sanctus Ignus record with Stefan Forde. Big thank, of course, to Stefan Forde, of course, and Dennis Ward. Basically, Dennis was mixing or producing that record with Stefan Forde at the time for Nothing to Say Records, a French label. And they were looking for a singer, and I was playing with Pink Cream 69 in France somewhere. And Dennis was producing the record, and Stefan was there, an incredible guitar player. Stefan Forde, check it out. He played on that record, of course, and had an incredible solo career up until now. And Stefan basically contacted me. I think it was an email, or I think even through Dennis, because that, you know, 20 years ago, there was no Facebook. I mean, and he said, look, you know, I want you to be on this record. And he sent me the stuff, and I have to admit, in the beginning, I was like, whoa, this is complex stuff. This is symphony air. This is dream theater, you know. But he had a lot of ideas for the melodies, so I kind of got an idea what he was looking for. I think the record had like 8-9 songs on it, and I wrote 4 of the lyrics, so it was nice to be involved in that respect. But fond memories, and I look back to those records and listen to them and enjoy them and listen to my young self. Sam Scott, hi David, hope you're well. Yeah, I'm not doing too bad, man. I'm optimistic at the moment. Third single's nearly in the can, Madam Medusa. We got Zibi on guitar. That was the reveal tonight. And the next video, hopefully, will be the reveal of the bass player, somebody from Spain. We got a German drummer. And we got on keys, we got Julien as well. And yeah, you know, Friday's going to be a big day for about 5 minutes. Hopefully I'll be feeling okay the day after this big happening. And we get on with life, man. Good to see you, Sam. Mark, great vlog again, David. Thank you, man. Thanks for everybody tuning in. It's just been incredible again. We got 23 people online, 23 people on last. Last week was a bit less, but it's growing, the channel's growing, the subscriptions are growing. That is really important, of course, the subscriptions. Because obviously if I knock some of it out, you know, and I still got loads of videos and of Pink Cream 69 and all sorts of stuff. If I knock something out, then you get to know straight away if you've got any friends who's on YouTube or watch a bit of YouTube and stuff, you know, send them a link, send it their way so we can maybe we can reach that 500 mark, you know what I mean? So work for you guys is, don't forget, keep sharing the video, keep listening on Spotify playlists if you know anything. Don't forget the t-shirts if you haven't tuned in with the t-shirt yet. This has been washed a few times actually, and it's still incredible, and actually it's getting a little bit more that rock and roll thing now. It's been washed a few times, and I've been wearing it a lot, of course, and people, it's incredible. I walk around and people say, look, you know, what's that t-shirt? Oh shit, it's your name, Dave. And I'm like, yeah, it's me, but oh, where can I order it? So hey, jobs are good, and you know, job well done. Thanks for everybody tuning in. We're coming up to the hour, and you know, don't forget, we're making this record together. The end of the month should be the third single. Big bulk of the record is already very far, but obviously I'm working on the singles. The reason that it's a little bit like this at the moment is that this whole thing started literally 2 months ago, basically, where we decided together we're going to make a record. And you know, this whole brainstorming, this whole happening, this whole thing has just happened in the last couple of months. So of course it's not been like I've spent years preparing this, you know. It's just doing it as we go, basically learning how to make videos, you know. And that's how I work best, actually. A bit of pressure, I come up with the best ideas and the best stuff, quite honestly. If I plan it ahead, it sometimes can be difficult because you're busy doing other different things. And this is the best way that I work, quite honestly. Ja, tut mir leid, Britta. Aber du warst ja am Anfang dabei. Anka says thank you so much. Adios. Once again, thanks for tuning in, everybody, of course. I'm going to go outside now and enjoy the evening a little bit, and maybe get out on a bike and enjoy the night air. I'm an outdoor kind of person, generally speaking, and these nights coming in, it is the where it's still light, of course, it's really nice. And wish you all the best, and yeah, let's everybody get this vaccine sorted out. Let's get back to normal, let's get our lives back, let's get on stage, let's enjoy life, let's rejoice life and celebrate life again. You know, that's what it's all about. Dewey, Arnold, Geweldig. Thank you so much, Sarah. Wünschen noch einen schönen Abend. Danke schön, Carola. Disponia. Drück die Daumen für deine Impfung am Freitag. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for everybody. Success from Mark. Everybody that's tuned in tonight, Adrian, Mark, Britta, Sarah. Arnold, Carola, Diana S, of course, from the US, Anakta, are my Japan amazing friends, Natsuko, Craig, of course. If I've missed you out tonight, I apologize, and I didn't mean it, but thank you so much, everybody, joining in. Don't forget to share those videos, you know, and get the message out there. And let's look forward to the third single coming out, Madam Medusa. And at this point in the game, there's only really one thing to do. Well, what I'm going to do first is time to switch off the machine. And then there's something that I always said in a different language. It's like bye-bye, but in a different language. Adios! That was it. Sid James.
My name's David Readman, and I'd like to welcome you to my Tuesday night fun and games live show. Every Tuesday night on YouTube at 8 o'clock. Come and join in. Hi, my name's David Readman, singer of Pink Cream 69, Voodoo Circle, and many more. And I've just released the second single, The Fallen, from my upcoming record, Medusa. K Came out on the 14th. Go and check it out. The Fallen is available on all good streaming sites. We're making this record together. Come and help me. Come and take a quick look. At the video on my YouTube channel. The link is below. Thanks for watching. Have a great night. Bye-bye.